Hi guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to make a mop, a broom, and a mop bucket. First thing you need to do is get yourself some twine. Then you want to go ahead and unravel it by twisting it. Keep twisting it and pulling it apart until you get it to where you have about a 2-inch length. And then you want to cut it. Okay, so now you want to get yourself some string of some sort. The thicker floss string works best. Pull it straight, and then you're going to glue a piece right in the middle, but fold it in half first to see where your middle is going to be, or measure either way. So just lay it on there. Put a thin layer of hot glue on it. Now you want to take a butter knife or some scissors or something like that and press it down with that so that you don't burn your fingers with the hot glue. This will allow it to get into the fibers a little bit more. And once you've done that, then you want to start folding it over a little bit at a time. And I am going to put some glue right on there. And then fold it. Continue this process until you have them all folded over. And again, I'm just using the scissors so that I'm not burning my fingers, because the scissors, the glue won't stick to. And if it does, it'll pull right back off. You can use a butter knife or something else to do that with. Okay, we're almost done folding it. Just be patient with the string if it starts to move on you. And be sure not to touch it with your fingers, because it will be hot. Okay. Now, once you have it all folded over, I am taking the string and pulling it to push the fibers closer together. Now, this is a little difficult because you've glued it down. But any loose fabric that you have in there from, you know, the rope or twine, whatever you want to call this stuff, will pull together. And that's what you're going for. All right. Once you have that, then you want to get yourself either a wooden dowel, a bamboo skewer, or some kind of round dowel looking object that you can use, and you want to cut it in about a 4-inch length, 3.5 to 4 inch, depending on how tall you want your broom to be and if you're using it for Barbie or if you're using it for 1/12 scale. Now, what I've done here is I've taken a glob of glue and I've made a thick amount on the end of the skewer, and I'm putting it on the rope that's hanging, and I'm folding it over a little bit at a time. And once I have everything where I want it, I'm going to cut that off. Okay, so once you have the rope wrapped around it, go ahead and cut it off to the length that you need it to be. And then you want to pull all the brushes downward and cut it straight. Now I'm just heating it up. I'm not actually applying glue here. I'm just heating up that glob that we applied in the beginning, because now that I have everything attached, I want that to flatten out, so that it will become a broom. And that is the purpose of making that glob. It gives that nice sturdy hold on those fibers. Okay, so now you can use some brown thread or green. I prefer green. I just think it looks better. Now, I actually doubled this up, but I would say, honestly, to do it single. Don't double it up. Unless you're using a thinner thread. This is like that floss that you use for like cross stitching and stuff like that. So it's a little thicker than normal. And I just think it's a little too thick. So next time I would only use one strand rather than two. And you'll see the difference in the two brooms where it's one versus two, because I put brown on the other one. Now you just want to go ahead and stitch this in, going back and forth throughout the whole thing, going all the way across. Make sure you're tying all the fibers in together and doing it in one side, out the other, and back in. And remember, glue is holding this all together, so it does not have to be perfect. It just has to look good. So, and it really doesn't even have to look good if you're not picky. But, that's all you need to do for this part. And then we'll just go ahead and move on to the next part, and I will show you the rest. Okay, so now we're going to just tie that off. And I added a little bit of glue before I pulled it through. That way the string stays inside with the glue on it. Now, I'm not applying glue here, but I am taking the leftover glue that is on the glue gun, and I am melting it on the fibers very lightly, so you don't really see the glue, but it's enough to hold it all together on the outside, too. This part is optional. Okay, so now you can use a miter box to cut this, but it's such a thin piece of wood. I'm just using my wire cutters, and I am rotating it in a circle as I do it so that I'm not pressing all at one time on one side. I'm just kind of rotating it around and working my way through it. And then snap it off. Lightly sand that at the top so it doesn't have an edge on it that's sharp. And you can paint the handle too. Alright, now this little mop was easy, and we're going to show you that next, so stay tuned. So you want to get yourself some 18 gauge jewelry wire. You don't really need the copper wire for this because it's not anything major. However, copper wire would be stronger. So if you prefer to have 18 gauge copper wire, you can do that. It's not necessary though. All right. Now you want to put it in the end of the pliers, and then you want to bend it around so that you're making a U shape on each side facing each other. Now you want to take your skewer or dowel, and you want to put it right in the middle of that. And now you're going to wrap the wire around it. Go left to right, so that they overlap each other, every other one. And then you're going to cut it off and then squish the part that you cut off into the round part of the dowel so that it goes with the flow. If your wire does happen to bend out of shape while you're doing this, it's not that big a deal. You can bend it back in shape. Okay, so now you want to push the skewer or dowel up just a little bit so that it's extended past the wire that you just twisted. The purpose of this is we're going to be putting crazy glue or super glue all up on that dowel. Just squeeze it right on there, and then once you have it good and coated on that dowel, then you want to pull it back over it to where it's almost covered completely, but you want to leave just a tiny bit hanging outward at the end. Should look like this. Okay, so I pre-cut this ahead of time, so I'm just cutting the string off of the middle. And this is just, again, the cross-stitching floss that you would use. And It's about a 2.5 inch length. You can cut it longer if it's easier for you to work with and then trim it after you're done. But you're going to slide it inside that little frame that we just made, fold it over in half. Make sure you have it even. And now apply a little bit of glue. You don't need a lot. This is basically just to help you hold it so it doesn't move on you while we're attaching the wire for the next step. Okay, so now you want to get your jewelry wire that you just used for the frame of it, and you're going to wrap it around it right below the frame of the wire brace. Squeeze it super tight so that it pinches it. Do that on both sides, and it should look like you have two pieces of wire sitting side by side when you do this, because they should overlap next to each other. Okay, so just make sure both pieces of wire is touching each other. So you want to pinch them together horizontally like I am here to make sure they look like it's one side by side. And it should be nice and tight. And that is pretty much it for this mop, other than trimming it up and painting it if you want it painted. And then that's all you'll need to do. You can, if it makes you feel better, put a little dab of crazy glue on the wire so it doesn't come off. However, keep in mind, when you're making these small miniature objects like this, they're not meant for children to play with them, because they are small objects and children can choke on the small objects, especially when you're using wire and rope like this that can easily come off with a child playing with it. So I wouldn't recommend you making these for children. However, they are great for the hobbyist. Okay, so that's basically it for the mop and the broom. Now, if you want to see how I'm making the mop bucket, I'll show you that. Just, you know, continue to watch. If you don't really need a mop bucket, you can end the video and just check out dollhousetutorials.com and the YouTube channel for more information and more tutorials. All right, so you can see you're still with me. So here's the mop bucket. I am just using a dipping sauce container that you get from a fast food restaurant, and I am wrapping the wire around it so that I can get the shape that I want, or close to the shape that I want. If you use something other than the bucket that you're using, the shape may not be the same. It may be too big or too small, so that's why I'm actually using the roundness of the bucket. All right, and now I've just bent the ends in just a tiny bit, and I'm going to poke a hole into the bucket using a needle. Now, mind you, this is just super thin plastic, so it's really easy to go through it. Go one on each side, And I'm just using a needle. So if you're going to use a needle, be very careful not to poke yourself, because trust me, it's not that hard. All right, so now that's done. And sorry about the voice over here. It's just kind of crazy and loud in my house today. So I just decided to do the voiceover for you to hear it better. Hopefully it's working out for you. All right, so now this is where I bent the wire over, and I am going to put it in here. However, right now I'm just test fitting it to make sure it's going to fit in there, you know, with the thickness of the needle and everything, and it does. So then I'm just adjusting it to where I can, you know, raise it up and down. However, if you're going to paint your bucket, you need to take the wire back off. Otherwise, you'll get paint on your wire. So I'm going to paint this bucket. And another thing you can do, which I did not do in this video, but I will do it, is I'm going to put a handle on the middle of the bucket using some tape, and then I'm going to paint the tape red. And I'm just going to use masking tape for that. But you can use duct tape too. And then just, you know, paint it with acrylic. And this acrylic paint, I will tell you, by far, out of all of the paints that I've used in the past, this brand is really nice. It actually is hard to get off of your hands after you paint with it. So if it's hard to get off of your skin, which most acrylic just washes right off, you can see how it would stick to the objects that you're painting a little bit nicer. And unfortunately, it does cost more, but again, you get what you pay for. So it's definitely worth it. All right, so I'm going to finish painting this, and then we'll move on to the rest of the bucket. Okay, so you know how you have your toilet bowl cleaner? Well, that's what this lid is. It's a toilet bowl cleaner lid. I just popped it off of there, and now I am just working on getting it cut down to the size I need. Now, you could do this on the saw and take the time and really have it nice and neat, but I'm not at my father's today, so I couldn't do it over there, so I'm just using a pair of cutters. And it's not hard at all to do that. However, be careful, because that plastic will, you know, cut your hand if you're not. All right, so now I'm using my titanium scissors, which titanium scissors are really strong and durable for a lot of things. They're not like the average, like Dollar Tree scissors or whatever kind that you would get that would be a little bit thinner. But I'm cutting it around, and I'm shortening it. To make it the size that I want it, and trying to make it a little bit neater. Once you do this, you can sand it down and everything, and it will actually, you know, look a little bit nicer. Right, so I have my red bucket now with my handle, and you can see how that fits in there pretty good, just like that. Now you can leave it like that and just have it in the bottom, and that would be the part where you would just kind of wring it out with. Or you can do this next step. Okay, so the next step is using the part that you cut off of the top and gluing it in there. And it's going to be facing up with the cone part facing upward into the point. See it just like that? You can leave it like that, or you could do this. Put some crazy glue or super glue all around the bottom of that part. And as you can see, it still has the hole there. Put some glue inside of there, and then you want to go ahead and put it down inside like that. And then the inside of the bucket will look like that. Okay guys, thanks for watching, and hopefully this was helpful for your little kitchen accessories. Don't forget to like and subscribe, leave a comment below. If you have a question or suggestion, drop it in the comments as well. And for free tutorials, free printables, free furniture templates, and more, go to dollhousetutorials.com. All right, thanks a lot. Have a great day.